We're closer to 2050 than the year 2000, and Premiere Pro still doesn't have a default way to apply implied camera shake to a video. Thankfully, there's a manual way to do it, so let me show you how. If you're looking for a quick way to add this effect, we actually have a wide variety of camera shake presets on storyblocks.com. But if you're looking to create something specific with your own creative touch, open up Premiere Pro and let's get started. So first, you should isolate the video clip that you want to add that handheld motion to. Then go up to Effects, Video Effects, Transform, and drag the transform effect onto the video player. Next, open the effects control so you can view the parameters. Now, looking at the effects on this clip under motion, they share many of the same properties as those within transform. So why add transform when you can just adjust the position and rotation under the motion effect? It's because you want to leave those for specific clip properties, such as slight repositioning, framing, or scaling the video clip when necessary. In contrast, the transform effect should remain solely for camera shake properties, since you'll be keyframing those later. So let's go ahead and right click, rename, and select camera shake for transform, so we know that this is what we'll need to adjust. Then go to position and rotation and activate the keyframes. Start moving the playhead forward a few frames and change the position on the X and Y axis by a few pixels, no more than 10 pixels in either direction. Do the same for rotation now, but with rotation, don't move it further than 0.1 or 0.3 in either direction. The more you move, the more harsh the shake effect will be, and realistically, you're probably looking for minimal camera movement here. Now go ahead and create different variations of these keyframes. Then copy these keyframes and paste them across the entire range of the video clip. Once you hit play, there's some pretty decent camera shake, but there's an issue with a blank background being visible. To hide that, you can increase the scale here to about 105, but that will ultimately depend on how far you took that rotation parameter. I also recommend adjusting the shutter angle to 180 degrees, which will introduce elements of motion blur. This is often a key component that's missed in camera shake plugins. And when you hit play, this is the final result. And the final bonus technique I'll leave you with is actually a set of presets that takes real handheld camera data and then converts them into keyframes within Premiere. These presets were created for the 2016 film Deadpool, so if they're good enough for Hollywood, then they're most likely good enough for your projects as well. You can check them out in the description. And as always, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments down below. And be sure to head over to storyblocks.com to get started with unlimited stock media downloads at one set price.